Hi all, this is Prasad and I am going to tell you today about Andhra Pradesh or Andhra in non-cooperation movement, the year 1920. So what are the consequences that led to non-cooperation movement and what are the incidents that took place in Andhra? So before going to non-cooperation movement, what happened before that? See, in 1919, the Rowlatt Act was passed by the British government, so which it empowers the executive to deport individuals and to press the press. That means to oppress the press, not to give or oppose the government in whatever the thing. And they set up tribunals to try political offenders. So these are the repressive measures that have criticized all over the country. So the Telugu press, especially Andhra Patrika and also Krishna Patrika, protested like anything. And they have written many articles against this act. Gandhiji asked the people to disobey the law by non-violent methods. And he also asked the country to observe 6th April 1919 as the day of fasting, prayer, and the day of national humiliation. So in Andhra, by the call of Gandhi, Andhra people responded enthusiastically to call of Satyagraha in many towns like Vishakhapatnam, Rajahmundry, Narsapur, Elur, Vijayawada, Guntur, Nellur and Chittur. Though the 6th April, the day was passed peacefully in Andhra, but at Vijayawada Taluk, at Kolavennu, they have protested vehemently against that act. They led to mass demonstrations, strikes, riots in many parts of the country along with Vijayawada. In Amritsar, the Jallianwala massacre was happened due to this act. On 8th April 1919, the prohibitory orders was passed on Gandhiji not to enter into the Punjab or Delhi. So people assembled at Jallianwala Bagh, Amritsar. The demonstrations are going on in Jallianwala Bagh. Suddenly, the dyer blocked the entrance and started firing without giving the instruction also. Almost 1,000 people was killed. This incident sent a wave of horror throughout the country. As a protest against this gruesome incident, the Rabindranath Tagore gave his award, the title of knighthood, to the government. So, on retaliating this, the district conferences in Andhra, Ganjam, Godavari, Krishna condemned this massacre. The Ganjam conference, the question of recall, Lord Chelmsford, Viceroy, came up for consideration. And in Nellur district, Tanguturi Prakasham Pantulu presided over the conference and he pointed a declaration of fundamental rights. So after this, the Khilafat movement was started all over the country, because the empire of Turkey was dismembered. Who is the spiritual head called as Khalifa of Islam? So the all Muslims in India participated in the Khilafat movement, which is headed by the Shaukat Ali and Muhammad Ali, both are brothers. So Gandhi also joined the movement and expressed his sympathy over the Muslims. So he presided over the Islamic conference at Delhi on 24th November 1919. So first time the Gandhi has preached his technique of non-violence and also non-cooperation. Then the Government of India Act 1919 passed by the Parliament to give effect to Montfort reforms. By the Montfort reforms, all political prisoners were released, which they were arrested through Rowlatt Act. They all were released. Whatever the reforms James Ford did, this doesn't satisfy the Congress. So under this new act, the elections took place in November 1920. So Andhras became anxious to safeguard their interest. We have very special interest regarding this. So the Andhra Mahasabha Standing Committee and the Andhra Provincial Congress Committee held its meetings, and they declared and proposed to the Government of India by these three following petitions. The first one is the Telugu districts should allot not less than one half of the total number of elected seats. So whatever the seats are there, one half from the Madras constituency, Telugu should be elected. This is the first reason. And for University of Madras, there should be two seats. These are called reserved seats. So they asked one seat to the northern district of Andhra. And also the four seats were there for Madras constituency in the Council of States. So they asked two seats to be reserved for Telugu districts. These are the three demands of Telugu people. In September 1920, the special session of Congress was held at Calcutta. Many prominent leaders like Konda Venkatappaya, Pattabhi Sitaramayya, Duggirala Gopalakrishnayya, Ayyadevar Kaleshwar Rao, and Peta Bapayya attended it. In that session, a resolution was done. So with that, non-violent, non-cooperation was accepted by overwhelming majority. This program includes boycott of all colleges, all legislatures, law, courts, whatever the government schools, and also to give up all the titles which was given by the British government. So actually the Andhras, the Konda Venkatappaya and also 30 Andhra delegates opposed it, because we have very special interest for Andhra Pradesh. So they have opposed this. Even they opposed, it was the majority people were accepted. So this became the resolution for the Indian National Congress in 1920. So Konda Venkatappaya was abided by the resolution, and also he resigned his membership in the Madras legislature. So the political situation in the country was very bad in that time. So all the persons all over the country withdrew their candidature to the legislatures or the elected bodies. Many meetings were held to boycott the elections and asking the graduates, merchants not to vote or not to exercise their franchise. In a similar way, in Andhra Pradesh, Konda Venkatappaya toured several districts and asking the graduates and also merchants to boycott the elections. As a result, very few people voted in the election. So, if we see in Guntur, only 15% of votes were polled. And in Rajahmundry, out of 120 Muslim voters, only one, that too, he is a government servant. So, he took part in the voting. And in Chittoor, 135 out of 534 in Grahamspet, that is on rural constituency. Recorded their votes. So Congress boycotted elections. As a result, Justice Party, which is formed to protect the interest of non-Brahmins, came to be successful. Almost it won 63 out of 98 elected seats in Madras Legislative Assembly. And the ministry was formed in 17th December 1920 with Subba Rayalu Reddayar as CM and other ministers are P. Ranganathayyar, Raja of Panagal and K.V. Reddinaidu of Eluru. In December 1920, the annual session of Congress were held at Nagpur under the presidentship of C. Raghavachari. At this session, Congress tone was changed. At this session, it laid down the object of attainment of Swaraj by all legitimate and peaceful means instead of constitutional means. So earlier they boycotted the elections, now they are getting Swaraj within 1 year through non-cooperation by all legitimate and peaceful means. So they make an U-turn. However, Andhra people enthusiastically responded to the call of Gandhiji. Guntur district took a leading part in the non-cooperation movement by organizing no tax campaign at Pedanandipadu and Forest Satyagraha at Palnadu, and Chirala Perala Satyagraha is also started by Duggirala Gopala Krishnaya. During this non-cooperation movement, Andhra people followed Gandhiji's leadership and made splendid sacrifices for the freedom of country. They inspired the leadership provided by eminent mind like Deshabhakta Konda Venkatappaya, Andhra Ratna Duggirala Gopala Krishnaya. And these are the titles, Deshabhakta and Andhra Ratna for both. Andhra Kesari, that is for Tanguturi Prakasham Pantulu. Deshodharaka, that is for Kasinadini Nageshwar Rao. All India Congress session was held at Vijayawada in April 1921. This session is most important event in the history of Andhra. Thousands of people came from all Telugu districts to attend and also for the darshan of Gandhiji and also important leaders. Chittaranjan Das, Muhammad Ali, Shaukat Ali, Motilal Nehru. Or at the session. The Andhras collected 1 crore rupees for Tilak as a Swaraj fund. In the same session, Pingali Venkaiya designed the tricolor flag for Congress. Gandhiji accepted it with slight modification. And subsequently, the flag with other modifications became the national flag of our country, which we are seeing now. That is designed by Pingali Venkaiya. So after this session, Mahatma Gandhi took a tour of coastal Andhra districts and addressed meetings at Kakinada, Rajahmundry, Eluru, Machilipatnam, Chirala, Nellur, and some other places. His tour created a great impact on all people, especially the women, who had till they have not taken part in any interest in public affairs. By the call of Gandhi, they came out to streets and attended the meetings. Some of the women like Duvuru Subbamma, Ponaka Kanakamma, Unnava Lakshmi Bayamma, proved to be excellent orators and political organizers. So the Andhras also joined in boycotting the visit of Prince of Wales. And the Hartal at Vijayawada was most spontaneous. It's a call of Gandhi. So we will conclude all the things what happened in Andhra in non-cooperation movement. So this non-cooperation movement, the resolution was taken in Indian National Congress session, which was held at Calcutta under the leadership of Motilal Nehru. They opposed the elections, they boycotted colleges, government schools, government legislatures, whatever the things started by British government. Firstly, Konda Venkatappaya opposed for our own safeguards of interests. However, later he also participated in the non-cooperation movement. Gandhiji also, in his general Young India, he commented about Chirala struggle, which was started by Duggirala Gopala Krishnaya. And forest satyagraha at Palnadu, no tax campaign at Pedanandipadu, hurdles at Vijayawada, and all the people not participated in the elections. So as a result, Justice Party won and they formed the ministry in Madras Legislative Assembly. Especially the demand for separate Andhra province, even though the Justice Party was dominated by Andhra leaders, it never supported the formation of separate Andhra province. The reason is that Andhra people are more diverted towards the non-cooperation movement. And Congress was very popular in Andhra region. And also the Justice Party, who are the Andhra leaders, are there, right? They never wanted to have a separate province which they won't get anything. In 1922, M. Surya Narayana
A member from Vishakhapatnam introduced a resolution in the Madras Legislative Council recommending the Madras government to create separate Andhra province. But the Justice Party ministers opposed it. The AP Patro, the educational minister, persuaded Surya Narayana not to press his resolution, but Reddy Naidu supported the demand for separate Andhra province. Reddy Naidu said the seeded districts means Kadapa, Ballari, Anantapur, these are the seeded districts which was given to British by the Nizam ruler. These districts are not interested for separate Andhra province. And the coastal Andhra people are very interested for separate Andhra province. This was said by Reddy Naidu in the Madras Legislative Assembly.